to my channel. My name is Emily. If you've been here before, thank you very much for coming back, and if this is your first time, you're welcome. In today's video, I'll be talking about how to work as a locum biomedical scientist in the UK. To work in the UK as a locum biomedical scientist, you will need to have the right to work in the UK. This right to work in the UK would be without restriction, so you can take up any job anywhere for any particular duration. So for this, you will need a valid passport and a valid visa. The second thing you would need would be relevant qualifications in biomedical sciences, and this will either be like a bachelor's degree or a bachelor's and a master's degree in biomedical sciences. This needs to be IBMS accredited so that you can work in the NHS lab, and also you can be registered with the HCPC. The third thing you will need to work as a locum biomedical scientist in the UK is an HCPC registration. This HCPC registration is the Health and Care Professions Council registration, which holds a register for all biomedical scientists in the UK. So to get on this register, you need to have an IBMS accredited biomedical science degree, and also you need to have completed the IBMS Certificate of Competency portfolio, and this is usually done over a period of a year in an IBMS accredited laboratory. And finally, the last thing you would need would be to have at least 12 months post-registration experience in the UK. This is usually required because you would need to go to different hospitals to work, and they need someone that actually knows what they are doing and someone that can hit the ground running. So you need to have at least a year's experience working in the laboratory. This experience is usually required to be UK-based or NHS experience, but some agencies can be lenient enough to take you if you have equivalent experience of working in an NHS laboratory. So if you've met these four requirements, which is to have the right to work in the UK, to have the relevant qualifications in relation to biomedical sciences, to be HCPC registered, and also to have 12 months experience working in the laboratory, then you can apply to various locum agencies to get locum roles. So for you to get these locum roles, these agencies will require you to submit some documents. These documents include the passport. They need you to have a passport and a visa, and this visa must allow you to work without restrictions. The second one they would need is for you to have these qualifications. So after you submit your passport, they will require you to submit your BSc certificate or MSc certificate, and also your IBMS certificate to show that you've actually completed your IBMS training in the laboratory. The third thing they will need is for you to submit the proof of your HCPC registration, which is usually in the form of your HCPC certificate. The next thing would be for you to submit your current CV. This CV should be detailed enough to highlight all your laboratory experience so that the agency can have an idea of what experience you have, so that when they are placing you for roles, they could gauge how much experience you've got. You'll be required to be DBS checked, and this is usually to check that you have no criminal record. In Scotland, it's called BVG, which is just to check that you have no criminal record, which can prevent you from working with adults or working with children. So it's just to check that you have no criminal record or any conviction against you. You might be required to pay for this DBS, but usually when you have worked for the locum agency for a while, they tend to reimburse your DBS back to you. The next thing they will require is for you to show a proof of address. They will usually require two proof of address that is within 3 months. This should be like utility bill, council tax bill, and like driving license or official document that shows that you live at the address. Two proof of address within the last 3 months. Also, they might require you to provide 5 years address history. This is just to show where you've lived in the last 5 years. And also, in relation to your DBS application, this address will be needed just to check your criminal record over the last few years. As part of your application, you'll be required to provide 2 professional references. This will be someone that you worked with, either like as a line manager or as someone that supervised your work. They will require details such as their email, their telephone number, and their address, just to make sure that, number one, you actually work at these organizations and you gain the experience that you said you've gained, and also just to check that you have good behavior and good standing to work with the agency. The next thing would be for you to complete a medical questionnaire. This is usually to check for infection, like you would need to show proof of immunity to like hepatitis B, hepatitis C, rubella, mumps and measles, and also things like chickenpox and tuberculosis, exposure to blood-borne virus, or if you've had any infection from like MRSA or like other deadly bacteria. This is just to make sure that if you happen to work in environments where you'll be exposed to all these dangerous infections, you are immune and you're protected from these diseases. So it's just to safeguard the agency that you've had immunity, so that if you happen to come in contact with this infection, they will be sure that you are protected to work in these places. You'll be required to submit a proof of this immunity. So if you had injections for like tuberculosis, measles, all these when you were a baby, you need to provide this immunity. And also for things like hepatitis B, you need to provide proof that you took the first, second and the third injection, just to make sure that you're fully immune. Final thing would be for you to complete some online training and also some practical mandatory training. Online training is usually set up for you by your agency. They would give you a password to a website where you will read some PowerPoints usually, then you answer some questions on it. This is usually things like health and safety, manual handling, fire safety and all the likes. Then they might require you to go for a practical training where you actually sit under an instructor and would actually have like a class where they will give you the lectures about all these things again. Things like fire safety, conflict resolution, infection prevention and control, moving and handling, preventing radicalization, information governance and data security, equality, diversity and human rights, then things like resuscitation, safeguarding adults and safeguarding children. So after this, you would be given a certificate which is valid for a year. So this mandatory training is something that you do every year, and every year you will get a certificate for it. This training usually come at a cost, and sometimes you would need to pay for that yourself, or your agency can cover the cost for you. So this concludes everything that you need to know if you want to start your role as a locum. So when you have all these documents, all you have to do is just to approach the locum agency or search for job online. Then you can get in touch with the agencies and you can start looking for jobs. Thank you very much for watching this video. If there are any other things you want me to cover, please get in touch with me in the comment section, then I will go through this. Thank you very much for watching once again. If you are a BMS out there and you like to become a locum, you can get in touch. Then I would share more information on how you can get started. If you've not subscribed to my channel, kindly subscribe, like and share my video. And I will see you in my next one. Bye for now.